Create and grade journals in Blackboard. Hello, and welcome to the world's fastest overview of how to create journals, how students will post them, and how to grade them. So the first thing that I need to do is I need to add a link to the journals tool onto my course menu. I do this by clicking the little Add Menu Item button, selecting Tool Link, typing in Journals, and from the drop-down selecting Journals, and then clicking Available to Users, and finally Submit. Now here's Journals down at the bottom. I want to drag that up and put it right below Discussions. So I've got my menu nicely organized, my course units, my media gallery, all the course content, and then here are the tools in this section of my menu. All right, now I'm ready to begin creating my first journal. So let's say that I've determined that I want to have a weekly journal that is a private journal. Journals typically are private reflection between the student and the faculty member. So I'm going to come down to Course Management and click Course Tools, and then click Journals. Now I'm going to click Create Journal, and I'm going to create Unit 1 Journal. All right, now it's a good idea to give students very specific prompts. Don't just let them write whatever they want to write. So for example, I've told students that I want them to discuss each of the ideas listed below and to discuss each of them in discrete responses and number them, and not to simply write one or two long paragraphs that touch on each topic. You'll get much better responses that way. It's also a good idea to give students a minimum word count, so they know generally that they have to write two or three paragraphs, for example. Once you've done that, you scroll down. I'm making sure that the journal is available. I can limit when the journal link is available to students by date and time. I can allow students to look at their entries monthly or weekly. Weekly is probably easier, but pretty much they're going to have just one post per week if you're having a weekly reflective journal. Do you want your students to be able to edit and delete entries? That's a good idea because sometimes people make a mistake. It's good for them to be able to go back and edit if they realize they left something out. Now, since it's just going to be you and the student, you probably don't want them to be able to delete your comments or their comments. Also, although you can permit any course user to view other students' journal, most people do not select this because this is typically a private communication between the student and the instructor. This is going to be graded. I'm going to make it worth 25 points. And I can decide whether or not I want students' posts to show in needs grading. I can give it a due date. I can add a rubric, etc. I'm not going to do either of those things right now, but you can. Now I'm going to click Submit, and I have my first reflective journal. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the Journals tool, and you'll see that if there were multiple journals in this course, the students would see each one of them, Unit 1, Unit 2, Unit 3, etc. And you would provide the students with instructions in your syllabus or in each of your course units, perhaps a little item reminding them to go into their journal and post in their reflective journal. So for example, I might go into Unit 1 and create an item. So I've created a little item. Just as a reminder, you can put this into every unit if you wish to. All right, now I'm going to go in as a student, and I'm going to respond to the journal, and then I'll show you how to grade it. So I click on the Student Preview button. Now I'm in here as a student. I'll click on Journals. I'll click on Unit 1 Reflective Journal, and I see the instructions here, and now I'm ready to post my response. So as a student, I click Create Journal Entry. All right, here are my responses. They're numbered. I would discourage students from attaching their response because it just adds one more step for you when you're grading. So I'm going to click Post Entry, and here is the student response. Now I'm going to exit the preview. I'm going to keep the preview user and all data so that I can go on and grade it. Now I'm ready to grade this student's journal. So I can go down to Needs Grading, or I could go to the Journals tool, either one, but I'm going to go to Needs Grading. I see that this particular student has posted to their journal for week one. I'm going to click on that attempt, and now I'm going to enter a grade for the student, and I'm going to enter some feedback, and I click Submit. And now you can see that that is no longer in needs grading. And if I go to Grade Center and go to Full Grade Center, because the Journals tool automatically creates a grade column, here's my grade column for Unit 1 Reflective Journal, and here's the grade that I just gave to my preview user. That is all there is to creating journal entries. It's the way that students will respond to them and how you grade them.